Good afternoon. It is, what day is it? Monday, the 23rd. Sorry, finding bugs. My tree lilies came. I have three. Well, three from this purchase, and then I was dumb enough to forget that I'd ordered these, because I forget when I've ordered things. So I ordered three more, but that's okay. I'll put some in my daughter's yard. She'll love them. This one is Lily Red Morning, and it grows to 72 inches tall. This one is Lily Anastasia, and it grows to 90 inches tall. And this is the tallest one. This is Lily Pretty Woman, and that one grows to 96 inches tall. And there's three in each bag. I have, what have I done today? Planted all my asparagus. I'm just waiting for the soil to settle to see if it needs any more on there. Can you see it all? Sorry. So that's all nice manured in and asparagus in. I have flattened out all this bed. I have nothing in here at the moment other than those old the tree lilies from last year, but this needs all cleaning up because it's a mess because I shoved dirt around and moved dirt around. So Gerald's making a back for me that matches those white. Those white things are the bed rails off of the metal beds that I buy. So they work great for back support. So there's a smaller one that's gonna go there. Then I gotta wait for all these marigolds and stuff to come out. And then when everything dies back, I gotta manure this bed. What else did I do today? I topped up the garlic. You can see the garlic's all coming up quite nicely, and they'll probably get topped up again. So far, so good. Knock on wood, knock, knock, knock. No tulip disturbance from the squirrels. And what else did I do? Split my raspberry. So these are raspberry bushes. This is, they don't get much taller than this. They get about this tall, and that's it. So I've split them and put some in here. They'll probably wilt, but that's okay. It's winter time coming. They'll die down anyway. And then I put the two raspberry, golden raspberry canes that I bought in here. And these ones need clipping down as well, it says, in the winter. So we may or may not do that because it says to do on canes that fruited. And I don't know which one's fruited because I bought them like this, although that one looks like it might have had a fruit on it. Who knows? So I don't know. Maybe I'll just do half of them or something. I have to do a bit more research on that. But having said that, if I cut them right down and they don't fruit next year, they'll fruit the year after. So I'm not worried about that. This is my disaster area. Got stuff all over the place. But anyway, that's what I've been doing today. So still got a bucket for old manure. Oh, and I did about 35 daffodils in pots. So that's good. And the sun's out today. So nice. It's so much better when there's some sunshine on your shoulders. Yeah, that's about it. Gerald's just putting all his tools away because we were moving a bunch of stuff around with his stuff. It's always heavy duty moving, so he has the tractor out. That's about it, I think. Yeah, so have a good day. Happy Monday. Bye. Oh my God, we've been out here all day. It's 4:15 and the sun's gone down. But that's what I've decided to do with the two red ones. It needs tweaking, of course, but that's what I'll grow my squash up next year. Or one of the squashes anyway. I'm not quite sure what I'm going to put on top. Like, I don't want to put too much pressure on the wood. But I might put some, get Gerald to put some legs on it. But it takes the pressure off the cage. But I can still grow underneath it. Maybe. We'll see. We don't know. Don't know yet. But, yeah. That's one more project done. Those two red ones are put there. I'm waiting for Gerald to pound the stakes in for me to hold it up so they don't fall down. Put the red trellis there for the hollyhocks, and I'm going in for my dinner. Bye. Have a great night. Bye. Oh my God, I stopped at the garden center. Look at the cyclamens. Oh, aren't they beautiful? I came to get pansies. Wow, those are pretty. Let's go around here and see what we got. Ooh, kales. Yeah, I need. Oh yes, we'll get some winter pansies to put in the baskets to liven them up a bit. Anyway, back soon. Bye. Oh gosh, it's cold. It's October 25th and it's 9 degrees and it feels like 3 because there's a wind chill. But I got all the bulb things done today. These are daffodils and some crocuses. And I bought some pansies for winter color. So I've covered what doesn't have a pot, a big thing in the pot. I've put, these are the cages that my flowers are in that are hanging out back. But because there's no flowers in them at the moment, I stole the cages back for squirrel protection. So hopefully that will help. And then there's bulbs in there as well. And there's bulbs in there as well. Like anything I can hide, right? Poor flowers are starting to look a little bit worse for wear. But if there's still bees around, which I doubt very much in this cold, I will keep putting stuff there for them. And just a quick view of the, those are the crocuses I did. Just a quick view of the bulbs. I showed you those ones, I think, already. But these are my other tree lilies. This is what I mean by you have to be careful what you order. I thought I was ordering a tree lily. It's a pack of five. So that's 11, 14, 17, 23 lily trees. Yes, insanity, I know. My poor strawberry plants are freezing. It's cold in here. It got down to one. It's supposed to drop to our usual November weather. Cabbages are still doing good. Our November weather, which is like 1 degree at nighttime. So I'll have to start fleecing stuff probably. I mean, the cabbages are doing fine and luckily nothing's eating them. But yeah, I don't know. Strawberries are holding on over there, but I don't think they're going to get any riper, even though they're big fat strawberries. So we'll see. Anyway, I'm gonna go in the house because my hands are freezing. Like my hands are freezing. I don't know if you can see that red and white. I have a circulatory issue with my hands, and when it's really, really cold, the ends of my fingers go white. But yeah, I gotta fleece things, and I'll have to do the tree lilies tomorrow. It's supposed to be a little bit warmer tomorrow, and I broke down and bought some cyclamen. They're so beautiful. Look at that. Isn't that cool? It's got a ruffled flower. So I'll have to do a bit of research on those as to whether or not they can stay outside in our stupidly cold temperatures. Anyway, have a great day. Happy Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. It's Wednesday, Wednesday. Okay, so we're gonna get some tree lily bulbs in between rain and cold and everything else. If you've never seen tree lilies, I'll put a picture of mine in. They get bigger every year, but this is the bulbs. These are giant tree lily bulbs, and they come in different colors, obviously, like most bulbs do. Am I showing you what you're, can you see what I see? There you go. So they will all go in this back corner. There's eight of them I'm putting in this corner. They get bigger, as I said, as they go along. So year one, year two, year three, they'll be bigger each time. I use my big bulb planter because the other one's too small, because they have to go 6 inches deep. So let's see if we can get some of these in before the weather changes. Keep moving that out of my way because I'm not using it yet. So let's put a couple back here. Okay, won't make you watch me do all of them because that would kind of be boring, wouldn't it? So I'll come back when I'm done. Okay, so got all of them. I got to cover them up with some stuff. Some more crates. These are just shelving tops off an old greenhouse. They come in really handy. So I got a whole pile in there. Forgot how many I forgot. I put one in that corner. I put two where that green stick is, and I put three where that is, and I put two at that end. Did I put two or one there? Anyway, there is one there, at least one. I put one where that stick is, one there, and one where that stick is. Just as much for my reference as yours, as God knows I forgot which ones I even put in there. I just mixed them all up. I won't know what they are until they come up next year, but that's fine too. Surprises are good. Garlic's doing really good. It stopped being really, really windy, so I decided I'd come out and finish up what I was doing. Did I put one at the edge of the... Yeah, I put one at the edge of the sweet pea bed as well, and two in the middle where the sunflower windmill is. So they're all over the place, and I've got three for my daughter, and two I'm going to put in the bed out front here by the house. Yeah, so that's it for me for today. I'm done. Done like the dickens. What's really weird is if you look, put something stuck to my shoe, obviously. My Acer tree has not even started changing colors very much, never mind dropping all its leaves. And it's the middle of, no, it's actually almost the end of October, 25th, and it's still got green leaves on it, which is really odd. But the newer ones, those are all like water shoots from this year. Gerald's got to prune them all down again, because I want it to be a compact tree. I don't want it to be a huge maple tree. So, yeah, the zinnias have still got buds and still opening. Even the buds look cool on these things. But for the most part, it's cleanup time. It's not doing anything else. Just cleaning things up. And I talked to the gentleman, Niall, at the garden center, and he said that was a cutworm that was on my brassicas. So I'm going to have to keep a really close eye on them and see how they do. Things in here, these are cauliflowers, they're not very happy with the cold, because like I said, it got super cold last night. But it doesn't look like there's any cutworm damage on this side of the bed. Still needs some manure, Demi, at the back there. I put all my little rocks back there until I can figure out what to do with everything in here. That bed section of the bed's got absolutely nothing in it. Yeah, not a lot going on. It's, like I said, it's been super cold. It finally stopped raining, but rain was fine because I can't get my burning permit if they don't, if there's not enough rain to saturate the ground, apparently. And look at this, a tomato. It's got a flower on it. I just noticed this now as I'm out here with you. It must have been a random seed or something, but it's got a flower on it, for goodness sakes. It's trying. It's trying very hard to be a tomato. That's a zinnia, so we just do that. There. Anyway, I am going in the house now. After I put these two bulbs in at the front, then I'm going to go in. Have a great day. Happy Wednesday. Yes, it is Wednesday. Got that right. So I just came out to water the things on the patio and just give them a tiny tickle of water just to keep them going. My dahlia's still going, dahlia, still going strong. But that's because she's up here. I don't think she'd be quite as happy if she was down there, which is fine. But look, where's my finger? Blueberry flowers. It's October 25th still, and I've got blueberry flowers and buds all over my miniature blueberry tree. Aren't they gorgeous? See, the fields and fields of blueberry trees. They're just, oh, gorgeous rust colors for acres and acres. It looks beautiful. Anyway, just tickety-booing everything to keep it alive and well. Have a great day. Bye. Gerald's cutting the lawn in between windstorms and downpours. I'm thinking it's a bit cold. It was -2 this morning. Ooh, dirty grass all over my feet. Gerald cut grass yesterday, thank goodness. Won't be getting much painting done today. Sorry about the shadow. It's morning, sunshine's behind me. I just came out to see if everybody's okay. Everybody being my plants. Ooh, brr. Oh, I think my potato might have had the biscuit. Let's check. Yep, look at this. Speaking of biscuits, it's like a limp biscuit. Yeah. Well, maybe we'll harvest them later, or maybe I'll just cut the top off and leave them for now. That's a spare hydrangea. Kales are doing fine. They don't mind the cold. Got lovely frost all over them. And that's my collards. Oh my, look at those. That's too funny. Oh, that certainly froze up fast. I might need to, no might about it. I need to get my fleeces out. But look at this. -2. Get my fleeces out and start fleecing stuff up. Because there's frost on the soil. Wow, that was quick. And yet, like I said, my Acer's not lost its leaves yet. Oh, brr. Oh, well. We knew it was coming. We knew it was coming. Just stand up. That's my windmill. My windmill. I'm gonna stand it up again for some reason. It's probably the moles underneath. When they dig holes, they make craters and things fall over. So I'll have to fix that. That's just gonna stay there for now. My poor, if that was a cutworm, I asked Niall at the garden center. He said, yeah, it was a cutworm. So I have to watch for them. But look at my poor brassicas. They're like, what are you doing to us? Sprouts don't look so bad, though. They don't seem to mind it at all. And the purple sprouting broccoli seems okay, but I will definitely have to put some sort of structure over things and see if I can't keep them a little bit warmer. The only good thing about all this freezing cold is it should keep the slugs at bay. I don't think they like being out in freezing cold. I have not seen one for a long time, knock on wood. That doesn't mean they're not out here. It just means I can't see them. Anyway, have a great day. Happy Thursday. Bye. Here we go again. Yikes. Whoa. Okay, is it the prettiest? Absolutely not. Will it work? Who has a clue? Would it freeze if I didn't put something on them? Absolutely. So I can only try, right? I'm not overly worried about the sprouts and the broccoli and stuff like that. That's not a big deal. But as we all know, I have babied my purple sprouting broccoli along all season. And I want them to be okay. So, yeah, I got down to -2 last night. And we know that's only the beginning. We don't get a lot of rain in winter here in Canada. We get snow and we get freezing temperatures. When the sun is out, look at that blue sky. When the sun is out here, it means it's ice cold. Like at most places, I guess. But yeah, it is a chilly one. Everything's just kind of crumbling and melting. I'm melting. I wanted to say to everybody who made such lovely comments on my video, how much it's appreciated that the support is there for gardeners from all over the world. We support each other, and it brought a few tears to my eyes, which I'm not a very cryy kind of person, but it did move me that everybody was so kind. And as I said to Carrie from Dog on the Pot, it's like Michael Jackson's song, you know, when he was the Jackson 5, one bad apple don't spoil the whole bunch, girl. And it's too true. We just take the good with the bad and we ignore the bad and just let them move on to whatever floats their boats. Anyway, have a beautiful Thursday. It's gorgeous. It's cold. It's maxed out at, woohoo, 9 degrees today. We've had to drain all the water and take all the hoses in. Yeah, have a good one. Bye. October 27th. We have to come out and switch the hummingbird feeder because it was frozen and they don't like that. But look, everything's frozen. Oh my god. Oh my giddy aunt. I don't think I'm going to be getting any bees coming around anytime soon. I mean, it looks cool, literally, no pun intended. But geez, Louise, it's frozen. -4 last night. Bird bath's frozen, solid. Maybe they could skate. I don't know, do birds skate? Doesn't stop Joel from coming around though, does it? Cheeky bugger, look at it. Anyway, let's go out back. I've got to wash my gloves, but I have to wait for them to come out of the ice first. Look at this. Oh, Lord. Oh, my goodness. That's the glass over top of my garlic. It's a gorgeous sunny day. Don't get me wrong. It's absolutely beautiful out. I won't blind you with the sun, but look, even my poor snapdragons are frozen. I think the bees have all gone to bed now. My watering can is frozen. My water butt. I had to fill that up because we've turned the hoses off. Even here, we turn the hoses off because they freeze and it can damage the piping in the house. I don't suppose anybody out here is very happy, are you? Being frozen cold. Lord. Yep. I think winter's here. Yeah, these guys aren't going to be happy at all. I don't know. Look at them. Oh my God, even my sprouts. I just have to throw something over you guys. I don't know. I might do the same as I did. What I might do is do the same as I tried to do here. Make sort of like a little booth for them. Ooh, just blinded myself looking up. And then I'm going to put maybe a pane of glass or two on top of this to stop the rain from drowning everything. We'll see. I can only do so much, right? It is winter after all. Yeah, zinnias and marigolds have bit the biscuit now. My carrots. Oh my gosh. I think I got frozen carrots. Frozen food. Oh well. Such is life. The hoses are hopefully okay. I think Gerald drained them all. Ouch. Walked into a stick. Anyway, that's about it. Winter's here, and I am done. Unless it warms up. It's supposed to be like 10 next week, but that means rain. So, you know, get one, you get the other. Everything's frozen. I think I'll put that inside, because even though it's winter, I don't want it to die freezing in the pot. Let's go see how everything in here is doing. I have to get a new thermometer. My thermometer that was outside broke. Oh, mother of pearl. Brr. -1 inside here. -1. Nice. Nice. Yeah, not a lot going on. Yeah, fleece is there to the ready, but I don't think they're going to help much. If it's -1 in here. I don't know. Well, they don't look too bad. They look better than the ones outside. Strawberries? Yeah, I think we're finally done. They're still there. They're just not going to get ripe. See? White strawberries. That one over there is getting red, but it's also getting frozen. So I've got frozen strawberries. How convenient. Do they ripen off the plant? I don't know. See, these ones here didn't get a fleece on them, and look how crinkled up they are compared to everything else. So yeah, definitely got to put more fleece on today and figure what I'm going to do. Anyway, have a great day. Happy Friday for those at work. Happy weekend. Bye. Improvising. Oh man, it's cold. My hands are numb. I just don't want the rain. The problem with fleece when you're outside is you fleece everything. And then the rain comes, the fleece gets soaking wet. Then it freezes again at night. Then you've got wet, heavy fleece on stuff. So I'm hoping that a couple of window panes, you see those window panes, will keep the most of the water off these. And the purple sprouting broccoli is tucked in there somewhere. There it is, there. Tucked in, crinkly, cold, but surviving. As long as it doesn't get down to -10 like it did last year, but I'm sure it will. But nothing I can do about it. It is Mother Nature's way. Have a great day. Bye. Time to start changing the hummingbird feeders. Frozen one in the house, new one outside. I think my poor dog has had the biscuit. It is frozen. It is dead. What do? Just cut it off and leave it in a pot? Or do I have to dig it up? Let me know. Bye. I'm thinking my Christmas lima has also bit the biscuit. It's looking a little worse for wear. And I didn't get my beans out in time, so they're all squishy. But that's okay, I've got more in the house. Anyway, so take that down today. Gerald's cutting some bed rails for me and for posts. Marigolds are toast. Like I said, -7 is not very conducive to being a happy plant. Hydrangeas are dead. Mushrooms are dead. And I don't know if that's a mole or could just be the ground heaves when it gets frozen. Don't know. I just don't know. As long as my bulbs are okay, I'm happy. But yeah, it looks like we've got some ground heaving going on. What the hell that was? Is I over there? Can't remember now. Anyway, it's bloody cold. That's all I know. Yep. Okay. Yeah, that's so weird. All the ground's pushed up. Anyway, frozen carrots. Yep. Yep, everything's frozen. Anyway, the sprouts seem okay now that they've got a cover over them. So we're hoping that they'll be okay over winter. But yes, even the bark mulch pushes up with the frost. Oh, Lord. Anyway, I got jobs to do. I will let you know what's going on later. Bye. Forgot to hit the record button. Idiot. These are the potatoes I got from the organic shop-bought potato I put in the ground. I put one potato in and I got what I would technically call 2.5 potatoes out. So that's not a bad deal, although I would have liked better. But now that I know I can do it, these are quite nice looking potatoes. Anyway, it's absolutely freezing in the shade. It's noon and it's still frost on the ground. It's insanely cold. Gerald's cutting stuff up for me. Good afternoon. It is October 29th. It's about 9 degrees. It's cold out. Anything in the shade is still freezing. I am making mashed garlic. And what I'm making mashed garlic for is I read somewhere that if you water with garlic water and some soap, then it can deter some critters. Now, I bought garlic cloves. They were 3 in a pack. For 67 cents a pack. So they had some nice purple ones in there. Whether they'll do anything or not, I don't know. But I thought, well, no point in doing all of them. Some of them were quite large cloves. So they might grow, they might not. So I'll just throw them in pots and stuff. But all the really tiny ones and the yucky looking ones and whatever, I'm mashing them up. And then I put them in my water bucket. This one, it's already got some garlic in it, and even just a little bit of garlic that's in there now, you can smell it a mile away. So we'll see how this works. What's the worst I've got? It's a lot of stinky garlic water, right? And you know me, I love a good experiment. So that's what we're doing today, is we're making garlic water. And I've got some eco-friendly dish soap. I'll throw that in there as well. Needs filling up a bit, so we're supposed to get a bit of rain in the next couple of days, which is good. So we'll see how that goes. Get some rainwater on everything. Yeah, so those ones I'll throw in pots, and the other ones, this is just going in the recycling. Yeah, it's chilly but sunny. Have a great day. Okay, and that is how you get everlasting poles. So free bed rails. This is hardened steel, free bed rails. These are the cross pieces. They make great anchors. Paint them, use them in the yard. They'll last forever. That's what I hold all my bed frames up with. Anyway, have a great day. Bye. Oh gosh, it's cold. So I fleeced the carrots. Whether it'll help or not, I don't know, but I've got spring onions in there as well, so I thought I'd better fleece them. And there's my trellis. That's all the things that everybody said I should paint red. I painted them red. So that's where the tomatoes are gonna go next year, hopefully. Anyway, have a great night. It's bloody cold. I'm going in the house. Happy Halloween. It's 4 degrees, but it's sunny. I bought myself some more baskets. These are really nice because they're heavy duty, like very heavy. And I'll paint them red like my other ones. Yep, that's a shadow because it's really sunny out today. So yeah, very nice. Nice deal. Smoking deal, man. Oh, and I put my, oh, poor flowers, put my hangers up. I painted them, gave them a fresh coat of black paint. These ones, I know they're hard to see from there, aren't they? That one there, I'm probably going to move because I realized it blocks my access to the bed. But see, this is another thing I use those railings for, is extra support for the hangers, because I can pound them right into the ground. Anyway, it's bloody freezing. I'm going inside for a coffee. Again, happy Halloween, everybody. Bye. Well, I ran out of paint. These are those new ones I just bought. These are going as side rails to a bed. These ones have all been painted and given a new coat. That one needs a new coat. I've got more paint that I've got to pick up. Yeah, other than that, brr. Look, oh, look, 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 look. I'm so excited. This is my mental health. Besides gardening, I get to burn. And no, we don't just burn for the sake of burning. We burn. We've got refuse and stuff to burn. So, my happy place.